Good afternoon. Thank you, Admiral. And we are all cricket-loving, we are a cricket-loving nation. So when the two opening batsmen have done a fantastic partnership with Admiral Dhawan and followed by Mr. Agarwal, there is always a tendency that the next batsman always has the laxity, you know, and is not well prepared for, because you have been waiting for your turn, and the partnership goes on so well that you forget that you have to play sometime every ball. So that's where I am. But having said that, this is something which probably, as some people say, is nowadays that it is there in my backyard all the time. Because I've been going there since 1991 in the Northeast and spent quite a lot of time there. From lookist, it has turned to actist. And as Admiral mentioned, we have stakes there because we have our neighbors in the Bay of Bengal. And I think for all practical purposes, it should be our domain. It should be our territory. So beginning with possibly somewhere down the line, having a common regulatory mechanism, including the certification and then classification of ships, etc. We are looking at everything that can happen in the Bay of Bengal together with India, Bangladesh, Myanmar, going right up to Vietnam. Now, we tend to forget that our longest international border, by the way, is with Bangladesh. Okay. And that is close to 1,400 kilometers, and all of that is actually through different rivers that Admiral mentioned. This part of our country and the neighboring country Bangladesh now used to contribute almost 26% to undivided India's GDP, and all of that on account of the connectivity, and that connectivity was again the water linkage. It was not the road link, it was the waterways connection that helped this region to contribute so much in the undivided India's GDP. So looking at this, there was a need that we engage with the neighbors, and then finally we've got this Indo-Bangladesh Maritime Treaty now signed, agreed. And with that, we have this access now to Chattogram and Mongla. Some of you would say, what is this Chattogram? By the way, Bangladesh has changed the name of Chittagong to Chattogram. It is Chattogram now. It is no more Chittagong. So Chattogram and Mongla are now being treated, are the dedicated ports, seaports that are available for Indian cargo, which is moving from rest of the country into Northeast or vice versa. If the cargo is being consumed or is being originated in the Northeast, then Mongla and Chattogram will be treating this cargo as a domestic cargo. It will not be treated as import-export. It has to go through documentation, of course. That is fine. But then there is no duty, other elements that are added to that. So that makes the life very, very easy and brings down the total logistics cost in the region. The entire Northeast pays almost three times the logistics cost than the rest of the country. This is simply because of the circuitous 1,200 kilometer route, land route that the cargo has to travel. Now, this region, the ACTIS policy talks about this region being the center. It does not say or does not see the Northeast at the periphery of India, but it sees Northeast as the center of the Southeast Asia region, and almost 80 million population in the region will be something that will be a market for the Northeast. And that is why we are looking at having various arrangements with these countries. The road access is already in place. Bangladesh, India, Bhutan, Nepal, the vehicles can now move without any separate licenses. The vehicles can move seamlessly through this region. The two transnational highways pass through this region. one starting from Tokyo going up to Istanbul, and the other one starting from Singapore connecting our Chabahar port and then further to North South corridor. And the trans border trade related initiatives, it is supposed to the goods are supposed to travel with single document throughout these transnational highway 1 and 2. All of this is going to give a lot of flip to the northeastern region economy, and then of course the blue economy in the Bay of Bengal, because we have got raw materials in the northeast and we import a lot of finished goods from Bangladesh. So there's a trade which is already happening, but that is hardly 5% of the potential. Our regional trade with all these Southeast Asian countries is absolutely minuscule. Absolutely minuscule. Probably less than 10% of its potential. While there are many regions in the world where the regional economies trade a lot, but we don't do that. Our goods coming from Bangladesh at times are transshipped in Singapore and they come to Indian shores, but they don't come directly. So all of this is now being addressed. There is a rail link that is already coming up between Silchar to Manipur, which will be further connected to Chattogram. So there will be a train that can move from Chattogram right up to Imphal and then further to Moray, which is the international border with Myanmar. And then from there you go right up to Thailand. The road that is constructed by India, the Maitri bridge and other things. So this is what is the new opportunity. Admiral also mentioned about Kaladan project, which is also an important project when you look at the entire economic activity and engagement with the neighboring countries. Kaladan is one project which will allow the goods to move into the northeastern states of Mizoram and Manipur via sea route. The distance is very short. We have already finished the construction of a port there in Sitwe. We are looking at the 100 kilometer road link which is to come up within Myanmar. There was a delay in land acquisition by the government there, but that's over now. The contract is awarded and the road should be in place. With that, the entire goods movement will start. 40,000 tons of rice moves into the state of Mizoram annually from the state of Chhattisgarh and Telangana. 40,000 tons. Now all of this goes by road so far. Yes, now we have got the rail link there. So there are goods trains which are moving. But imagine all of this moving via Vizag or Paradip into Kaladan and then upstream the river Kaladan, going up to Sitwe and then Kaladan River up to the border of Mizoram. There's a huge, huge saving. Similarly, the goods coming from Northeast, including the finished, oil products, there's a great demand. Bangladesh requires oil products and they import from various countries and very little from us. Now there's a pipeline that is coming up. Similarly, on the Brahmaputra, there's going to be ports that will be constructed, which will allow the petroleum products to go directly into Bangladesh. There's a proposal to build 19 ports on Brahmaputra, 11 in Assam, 5 in Meghalaya, and the remaining are in further Barak Valley and Tripura region. So all of this will completely change the logistics platform and thereby the economic activity. Because, as they say, initially, how do you end up having the economic corridors or the economic regions? Initially, it starts as a trade corridor, then it becomes an investment corridor, and then it becomes the trade economic corridor. So slowly, we want to see this new corridor that will emerge, and that will throw a huge opportunity which today is latent, or today it is unnoticed. I think very few of us know that 60% of Godrej healthcare and personal care products actually are manufactured in the Northeast. Okay, they have 3 factories in the Northeast, but then it's just not happening with the other people. It is, so there's a huge opportunity that is there. And all of this will happen through these various initiatives that the government has taken. Of course, I will not spend time on the road construction and the air connectivity that is happening, because that is also going to complement the blue economy. Because the number of airports that are coming up there, the road connections, because the exotic flowers or the medicinal plants or the other things that are available in the entire Northeast, unfortunately, do not reach the primary level of processing. Forget about the secondary and tertiary level. Even the primary processing does not happen because there are no roads. There is a serious lacuna of the warehousing facility, whether the normal warehousing or a temperature controlled warehouse. The container today, which is imported, and which is the cargo which is destined for say Shillong, gets unloaded at Calcutta port. And then from there it is de-stuffed, and the whole cargo de-stuffed from a container moves up into Guwahati, and from Guwahati then it is again transshipped, and then it goes to Shillong. There is no reason. I mean, you have now the connectivity, the sea connectivity, the water connectivity, which is coming up. The one multimodal port that was mentioned in Mr. Agarwal's presentation, Jogigopa, it's an ideal site. I mean, Jogigopa is a place which is on the Brahmaputra. There is a rail link, there is a road link already. So you have all the three modes of transport available at Jogigopa with 1,200 acres of land adjacent to the Brahmaputra. Now these are the opportunities which will transform the entire economic activity in the Northeast and then Bay of Bengal, because all of this is linked to the prosperity of 80 million people that live in this entire region. I think I just wanted to share with you that this is a new sector, this is a new area. And this economic activity is linked to not just the water transportation, but also today if you look at some of the reports, the average year-on-year growth in the online e-commerce platform, the highest is Northeast. The highest is Northeast, because this huge, the per capita income there, or I would say the purchasing power there in the Northeast is really high. There are various reasons to it. Let's not get into it because it will unnecessarily create some kind of a political statement. But having said that, as a businessman, if I look at it, there's opportunity. Many of you would not know that Shillong has the second highest vehicle density in the country next to Mumbai. Okay, that's the simple indicator of what, I mean, how much money and the purchasing power lies there in the people in the Northeast. And so therefore, this is a new region. Please have a look at it. There's going to be a huge opportunity that is going to open up there